Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Medical Hub. Before starting my video, if you like my video then please subscribe my channel and watch more videos. So now let's start. In this video there are 50 multiple choice questions with answers of gynecology. These questions are very important in competitive exams of nursing and medical. So let's see. Question number first. The condition in which bleeding is so irregular and excessive that it is difficult to identify menstruation is known as. There are four options. A. Menorrhagia, B. Hypermenorrhea, C. Metrorrhagia and D. Menometrorrhagia. Right answer is D. Menometrorrhagia. Menometrorrhagia is the condition in which bleeding is so irregular and excessive that it is difficult to identify menstruation. Next question, question number second. Which of the following tumor marker is used for diagnosis of ovarian germ cell tumor? There are four options. A. LDH, B. TAG72, C. SSC, D. CA125. Right answer is LDH. LDH is a tumor marker that is used for the diagnosis of ovarian germ cell tumor. Next question, question number 3. Excessive amount of cyclic bleeding at normal intervals is termed as. Option A. Menorrhagia, B. Metrorrhagia, C. Epimenorrhea and D. Dysmenorrhea. Right answer is A. Menorrhagia. Menorrhagia is the excessive amount of cyclic bleeding at normal intervals. Next question is question number 4th. What is the full form of DUB? Option A. Direct uterine bleeding, B. Direct uterine blood vessels, C. Dysfunctional uterine bleeding and D. Dysfunctional uterine blood vessels. Right answer is C. Dysfunctional uterine bleeding. The full form of DUB is dysfunctional uterine bleeding. Next question, question number 5th. In following which is a common cause of menorrhagia? Option A. Fibroid uterus, B. Adenomyosis, C. DUB or dysfunctional uterine bleeding and D. All of the above. Right answer is D. All of the above. A common cause of menorrhagia is fibroid uterus, adenomyosis and DUB. So right answer is D. All of the above. Next question, question number 6. Cyclic bleeding in which duration of MC is reduced to 21 days or less is termed as. Option A. Menorrhagia, B. Metrorrhagia, C. Epimenorrhea and D. Dysmenorrhea. Right answer is C. Epimenorrhea. Cyclic bleeding in which duration of menstruation is reduced to 21 days or less is termed as epimenorrhea. Next question, question number 7. The condition in which complete uterus turns backwards in relation to the long axis of the birth canal is termed as. Option A. Retroversion of the uterus, B. Antiversion of the uterus, C. Prolapse of uterus and D. Antiflexion of uterus. Right answer is retroversion of uterus. Retroversion of uterus is the condition in which complete uterus turns backwards in relation to the long axis of the birth canal. Next question, question number 8. Most commonly used and effective treatment of vaginal trichomoniasis is. Option A. Cefaxim, B. Use of oral contraceptives, C. Metronidazole and D. Gentamicin. Right answer is C. Metronidazole. Metronidazole is the most commonly used and effective medicine that is used for the vaginal trichomoniasis. Next question, question number 9. Collection of mucus into the fallopian tube is called as. Option A. folliculitis, B salpingitis, C hydrophile, and D hydrosalpings. Right answer is D, hydrosalpings. Hydrosalpings is a condition in which collection of mucus in the fallopian tube. Next question, question number 10. Polymenorrhea is also termed as option A menorrhagia, B metrorrhagia, C epimenorrhea, and D dysmenorrhea. Right answer is C, polymenorrhea. Polymenorrhea is also known as epimenorrhea. Next question, question number 11. The condition that rises the scrotal temperature includes option A filariasis, B varicocele, C big hydrocele, and D all. Right answer is D, all of the above. The condition that rises the scrotal temperature includes filariasis, varicocele, and big hydrocele. So right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 12. A male with hypospadiasis is option A unable to produce sperm, B unable to deposit sperm in vagina, C unable to pass urine, and D unable to deposit sperm deep in vagina. Right answer is D, unable to deposit sperm in deep vagina. A male with hypospadiasis unable to deposit sperm in deep vagina. Next question, question number 13. Congenital factor relate to male that is responsible for infertility includes option A undescended testis, B hypospadiasis, C Carthagener syndrome, and D all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Congenital factor that relate to male is responsible for infertility includes undescended testis, hypospadiasis, Carthagener syndrome. So right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 14. Absence of menstrual cycle in a female during reproductive period is termed as option A amenorrhea, B hypomenorrhea, C dysmenorrhea, and D epimenorrhea. Right answer is A, amenorrhea. Absence of menstrual cycle in a female during reproductive period is termed as amenorrhea. Next question, question number 15. When the menstrual bleeding is very less and lasts for less than 2 days is termed as option A menorrhea, B hypomenorrhea, C dysmenorrhea, and D epimenorrhea. Right answer is B, hypomenorrhea. When the menstrual bleeding is very less and lasts for less than 2 days is termed as hypomenorrhea. Next question, question number 16. Irregular acyclic bleeding from the uterus is termed as option A menorrhagia, B metrorrhagia, C dysmenorrhea, and D epimenorrhea. Right answer is B, metrorrhagia. Irregular acyclic bleeding from the uterus is termed as metrorrhagia. Next question, question number 17. Normal position of uterus in pelvic cavity is option A retrovited and retroflexed, B retrovited and antiflexed, C antivited and retroflexed, and D antivited and antiflexed. Right answer is D, antivited and antiflexed. Normal position of uterus in pelvic cavity is antivited and antiflexed. Next question, question number 18. Clinical manifestation of pelvic inflammatory disease includes option A lower abdominal pain, B fever, C irregular and excessive vaginal bleeding, and D all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Clinical manifestation of PID or pelvic inflammatory disease includes lower abdominal pain, fever, irregular and excessive vaginal bleeding. So right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 19. Vaginal trichomoniasis is more harmful when option A pH of vagina ranges between 1 to 2, B pH of vagina ranges between 3 to 4, C pH of vagina ranges from 6 to 7, and D no effects of change in pH. Right answer is C. pH of vagina range between 6 to 7. So vaginal trichomoniasis is more harmful when pH of vagina range between 6 to 7. Next question, question number 20. Following tests are done to identify HIV infection except option A, ELISA, B, Western blot, C, polymerase chain reaction, and D, Vidal test. Right answer is D, Vidal test. Vidal test is not used in the identification of HIV infection because a Vidal test is used in typhoid fevers. Next question, question number 21. In following, which is the most reliable method to diagnose PID or pelvic inflammatory disease? Option A, laparoscopy, B, cholecystectomy, C, sonography, and D, blood examination. Right answer is laparoscopy. Laparoscopy is the most reliable method to diagnose PID or pelvic inflammatory disease. Next question, question number 22. STD or sexually transmitted disease, lymphogranuloma benarium is caused by? Option A, Trypanema pallidum, B, Chlamydia trachomatis, C, Haemophilus decreti, and D, HIV. Right answer is B, Chlamydia trachomatis. STD or sexually transmitted disease, lymphogranuloma venereum is caused by Chlamydia trachomatis. Next question, question number 23. State of abnormal uterine bleeding in which there is no clinically detectable pelvic pathology is present is known as? Option A, menorrhagia, B, polymenorrhagia, C, dysfunctional uterine bleeding or DUB, and D, dysmenorrhea. Right answer is C, dysfunctional uterine bleeding or DUB. Dysfunctional uterine bleeding is a state in which abnormal uterine bleeding is there, is no clinically detectable pelvic pathology is present. Next question, question number 24. In following, which hormonal therapy is used for the management of DUB? Option A, contraceptive pills, B, norethindrone acetate, C, 17-alpha ethanol testosterone, and D, all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 25. Treatment of premenstrual syndrome includes or PMS syndrome includes? Option A, use of bromocriptine, B, use of antidepressants, C, pyridoxine, and D, all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Treatment of PMS or premenstrual syndrome includes use of bromocriptine, use of antidepressant, and pyridoxine. So right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 26. Following are the indications of endometrial resection in a female with DUB except? Option A, female who is over 35, B, female who has completed her family, C, female who does not has any significant endometrial pathology such as cancer, and D, female who is newly married. Right answer is D, female who is newly married. Next question, question number 27. PID or pelvic inflammatory disease is more common in following females? Option A, menstruating adolescent girls, B, having many sexual partners, C, previous history of PID, and D, all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 28. In a female, possibility for occurring acute endometritis is more? Option A, after menopause, B, after menarche, C, after abortion or childbirth, D, during childhood. Right answer is C, after abortion or childbirth. In a female, possibility for occurring acute endometritis is more in after abortion or childbirth. Next question, question number 29. In following, which statement is false? Option A, PID is common in females who are menstruating. B, PID is more common in women who are using intrauterine device. C, PID is more common in women who are taking oral contraceptives. And D, PID is less common in women having only single sexual partner. Right answer is C. PID is more common in women who are taking oral contraceptive pills. This statement is false. Next question, question number 30. What is the common cause of senile vaginitis? Option A, increased FSH level. B, malnutrition. C, estrogen deficiency. And D, androgen deficiency. Right answer is C, estrogen deficiency. The common cause of senile vaginitis is estrogen deficiency. Next question, question number 31. After HIV infection, there is immunodeficiency mainly due to option A, decreased number of CD4 T lymphocytes. B, increased number of CD4 T lymphocytes. C, decreased number of RBC. And D, increased number of RBC. Right answer is a decreased number of CD4 T lymphocyte. After HIV infection, there is immunodeficiency mainly due to decreased number of CD4 T lymphocyte. Next question, question number 32. Who discovered human immunodeficiency virus or HIV virus? Option A, Pasteur and Friedman. B, Robert Hooke. C, Watson. And D, Vere Sinoisi. Right answer is D, Vere Sinoisi. Vere Sinoisi discovered the HIV virus or human immunodeficiency virus. Next question, question number 33. Inflammation of vagina in a woman after menopause is called as option A, toxic shock syndrome. B, senile vaginitis. C, chlamydial vaginitis. D, chronic vaginitis. Right answer is B, senile vaginitis. Inflammation of vagina in a woman after menopause is called as senile vaginitis. Next question, question number 34. Presence of yellowish or blood mixed vaginal discharge after menopause and vulval pruritus are the manifestation of option A, menopause. B, toxic shock syndrome. C, senile vaginitis. And D, atypical menorrhagia. Right answer is C, senile vaginitis. Presence of yellowish or blood mixed vaginal discharge after menopause and vulval pruritus are the manifestation of senile vaginitis. Next question, question number 35. In following, which is a characteristic feature of pyogenic salpingitis? Option A, it is sexually transmitted. B, it is always bilateral infection. C, it occurs mainly during and after menstruation. C, infection occurs mainly after abortion and childbirth. Right answer is D, infection occurs mainly after abortion and childbirth. So, characteristic feature of pyogenic salpingitis is the infection occurs mainly after abortion and childbirth. Next question, question 36. In following, which is the most common cause of vaginitis in the childbearing period? Option A, trichomoniasis. B, atropic vagina. C, streptococci. And D, staphylococci. Right answer is A, trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis is the most common cause of vaginitis in the childbearing period. Next question, question 37. In following, which is not a characteristic features of gonococcal salpingitis? Option A, it is transmitted by unprotected sexual act. B, it is always bilateral infection. C, it occurs mainly during and after menstruation. And D, it is always unilateral infection. Right answer is D, it is always unilateral infection. It is always unilateral. Infection is not a characteristic features of gonococcal salpingitis. Next question, question number 38. What do you mean by delayed menopause? Option A, when menopause does not occur beyond 45 years of age. B, when menopause does not occur beyond 40 years of age. C, when menopause does not occur beyond 50 years of age. And D, when menopause does not occur beyond 55 years of age. Right answer is D. When menopause does not occur beyond 55 years of age, it's a meaning of delayed menopause. So delayed menopause is when menopause does not occur beyond 55 years of age. Next question, question number 39. Painful menstruation is termed as option A, menopause, B, dysmenorrhea, C, amenorrhea, and D, menorrhagia. Right answer is B, dysmenorrhea. Painful menstruation is termed as dysmenorrhea. Next question, question number 40. Causative organism responsible for moniliasis is option A, Candida albicans, B, Tinea cruris, C, Staphylococcus aureus, D, Gonococci. Right answer is D, Candida albicans. Causative organism responsible for moniliasis is Candida albicans. It's a yeast infection or fungal infection. Next question, question number 41. Clinical manifestation of genital prolapse includes option A, dysuria, B, backache, C, difficulty in passing stool, and D, all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. Clinical manifestation of genital prolapse includes dysuria, backache, difficulty in passing stool. Right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question 42. The type of uterine prolapse in which the uterine body protrude outside the introitus. Option A, first degree, B, second degree, C, third degree, and D, fourth degree. Right answer is C, third degree. The type of uterine prolapse in which the uterine body protrude outside the introitus is third degree of uterine prolapse. Next question, question number 43. When a female moves about, she feels that something is coming down through vagina, the female is suffering from option A, DUB or dysfunctional uterine bleeding, B, genital prolapse, C, rectovaginal fistula, D, cervical cancer. Right answer is B, genital prolapse. When a female moves out, she feels that something is coming down through vagina, the female is suffering from genital prolapse. Next question, question number 44. Degree of uterine prolapse in which the external os descends outside the vaginal opening but the uterine body does not protrude and still remains inside the uterus. Option A, first degree, B, second degree, C, third degree, and D, fourth degree. Right answer is B, second degree. In second degree of uterine prolapse, the external os descends outside the vaginal opening, but the uterine body does not protrude and still remains inside the uterus. It's a second degree of uterine prolapse. Next question, question 45. The structures which provide support to the uterus includes option A, round ligament, B, broad ligament, C, cervicovaginal junction, and D, all of the above. Right answer is D, all of the above. The structure that provides support to the uterus includes round ligament, broad ligament, and cervicovaginal junction. So right answer is D, all of the above. Next question, question number 46. Etiological factor responsible for genital prolapse includes following except option A, postmenopausal atrophy, B, raised intra-abdominal pressure, C, decreased weight of the uterus, and D, congenital weakness of the supporting structure of the uterus. Right answer is C, decreased weight of the uterus. Decreased weight of the uterus is not an etiological factor that was responsible for genital prolapse. Next question, question 47. In following, which is the most important acquired predisposing factor in genital prolapse? Option A, injury to the supporting structure during vaginal delivery. B, congenital and acquired weakness of the supporting structure of the uterus. C, undernutrition. And D, increased weight of the uterus. Right answer is A, injury to the supporting structure during vaginal delivery. So it's the most important acquired predisposing factor in genital prolapse, injury to the supporting structure during vaginal delivery. Next question, question number 48. In Kurtz-Jenner syndrome, option A, excessive production of sperm. B, there is loss of ciliary function in sperm motility. C, ability of sperm to penetrate ovum increase. D, ability of vaginal canal to receive sperm increase. Right answer is B, there is loss of ciliary function and sperm motility. In Kurtz-Jenner syndrome, there is loss of ciliary function and sperm motility. Next question, question 49. Which is the common chromosomal abnormality in azoospermic male? Option A, Down syndrome. B, Turner syndrome. C, Klinefelter syndrome. And D, Kurtz-Jenner syndrome. Right answer is C, Klinefelter syndrome. The common chromosomal abnormality in azoospermic male is Klinefelter syndrome. Next question, question number 50. Testicular failure due to deficiency of gonadotropin is termed as? Option A, Klinefelter syndrome. B, Kallmann's syndrome. C, Kurtz-Jenner syndrome. And D, Young's syndrome. Right answer is B, Kallmann's syndrome. Testicular failure due to deficiency of gonadotropin is termed as Kallmann's syndrome.